Good morning, students. Today our topic is Python programming, and in this lecture we are going to discuss some output based question answer based on Python programming. In our last lecture we solved some numericals or some programs based on question output based, and in this lecture we are also do this again. So let's start. Now this is our first program. You can easily see on the screen. This is a question based on nested loop, and we have to find out the output of this program. Okay, this is the program. You can easily see on the screen. Now the question is, what is the output of this program? If we execute this program in our computer system using Python programming, what will be the output? Now we have to calculate the output without executing this program, and you can easily see that first loop is for loop, second loop is again for loop, so loop under loop is there, that means nested loop is there. And when we see the condition of first for loop, you can easily see that for x in range 3, we already know that in range function, three parameters value should be given. These are initial value, last value, and increment and decrement. But there is only one value given here. It doesn't mean that there is an error. It means only that all other values should be considered as a default values, and one value which is given is considered as a last value. So 3 is the last value and 0 is the initial value by default, and 1 is the by default increment is there. So it actually means that range 0, 3, 1. So this loop starts from x is equal to 0 and then execute for x equal to 1 and then execute for x equal to 2. Because we already know that x is last value is not included in case of range function. So 3 for this loop will not execute for the x is equal to 3. Now one thing is very clear, that first loop execute 3 times for x equal to 0, for x is equal to 1, and for x equal to 2. Now let us talk about the second loop, which is an inner loop. So this is our first loop for x in range is equal to, for x in range 3. Now the inner loop says that for y in range 4. So same condition here. And it is an inner loop, as you know that, because this loop is defined under a loop. So first loop is called the outer loop and second loop is called the inner loop when we talk about a nested loop. So again, there are four different values of y for which this loop will execute, and these are y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, y is equal to 2, and y is equal to 3. So these are the four different values for which the loop will be executed. Now for first time, now let us talk about the third statement, that is a print statement, and that is a part of inner loop, print x comma y comma x plus y. So this will actually print the value of x, means the value of the outer loop, then y means the value of the inner loop, and the sum of the value of the outer loop and the inner loop at any point of time. So this will gives you an output according to that. Now let us talk about the first condition. Well, first condition is x in range 3. It means x will be executed for x is equal to 0. So for first time, x is equal to when loop is executed first time, x is equal to 1, x is equal to 0. And then for y in range 4, then y is also 0 because loop starts from 0. So x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0 in this case. And 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. So first of all, 0, 0, 0 will be printed on a screen. And then value of x remains same, but the inner loop execute for different values of inner loop will be executed for x is equal to 0, and value of inner loop will be changed from 0 to 1, then 2, then 3. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3 will be printed for first value of x is equal to 0. I think now the concept is very much clear to all of you. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0, 3 will be printed when x for x is equal to 0. and when x is equal to 1, then again inner loop will be executed 4 times. So 10, 11, 12. Okay, wait a minute. So inner loop will be executed again 4 times for x equal to 1. So 11. Here one thing should be noticed, that the sum will also be printed here. So we have not to print only the value of x and y, we have also print the sum of these values. So whatever be the value of x and y at any point of time, their sum should also be printed. Okay, and so suppose at any point of time x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1, so the output will be 112. Okay, and if y is equal to 2 and x equal to 1, then output will be 123. So this will be the output. But the main important thing is that for every outer value of x, inner loop will be executed 4 times. That is the concept of this program. And what are the different values of x? Are there value of x are 0, 1, 2. These are the 3 different values. And for all these 3 different values, inner loop will be executed 4 times. So total means total 3 into 4, total 12 values should be printed. And according to that, x, y and sum of x, y should be printed. So let us check about what is the output of this program. Is it according to our expectation or not? I think now the concept is very much clear to all of you. So first value should be x 0, 0 and 0. Second value will be 0, 0 and 1, and third value is 0, 2, 2, and fourth value is 0, 3, 3, because 0 plus 3 is equal to 3. And then loop will execute it for second time, and this process is going on for until we found the value of x is equal to 3. When we found x equal to 3, loop is over. So let us try to execute this program and let us see. If there are 12 different values and or not. Okay, you can easily see that. Just execute this program on a screen. Just save the program first. Now you can easily see that. Okay, that is the output. 12 different values are there. Let us write this output again and see what is the output according to this program when this is the output here. Now you can easily see that what is the process going on here. When we execute this program, for different values of x, different values of y will be printed, and of course the sum is also given. So sum of x and y should also be printed at that time. You can easily see that. So for 0, inner loop will be executed 4 times. So 0 is 0, 0, and third value is the sum of first 2 values. Always remember that. So total 12 times this program will be printed on a screen. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 2, 2, 0 plus 3 is equal to 3. So 3 is the so 3 is the third value. Same in 1, 0, 1. So in basically the nested loop type questions, one thing should be remembered, that for each outer value, inner loop will be executed according to that conditions. So first of all, find out the different values of outer loop, and according to that calculate the different values of inner loop. That is the main concept of finding out the values when there is a nested loop. Now this is the output. You can easily see that you can calculate that. That is output 0000011. Total 12 values should be there, and exactly 12 values are there. And third value is the sum of previous two values. Now let us take another program. You can see easily see here. This program is again based on a nested loop, and you can easily see that there is a variable declared as a c. C is equal to 0 initially, so it is, I think it should be a container value, or we can say that the output will be stored in the value of, in the variable c. Here you can easily see on the screen. And then there is a two loops, outer loop and inner loop, because nested loop is there, and the outer loop, first loop is called the outer loop in nested loop, and second loop is called the inner loop. So in you can easily see that what is going on here. Let us, same concept here. So I don't think that there should be any problem. You can easily see that actually multiple of 5 will be printed. And why it is so, I think you all are aware now the concept of the inner loop. So you can easily calculate the value of x and y in this case. Now here's the concept. C is equal to 0 for x in range 10. So first of all, in range function there is only single value declared here. So that is the last value, of course, and by default, as we know, that starting value is 0 and increment is 1. So it means that for x in range 0 comma 10 comma 1, and as we know that last value is not included in that in case of range functions. So loop will be executed for x is equal to 0, x equal to 1, x equal to 2, up to x is equal to 9. Okay, now the inner loop says that for y in range 5, it means the value of y are 1, 0, comma 1, comma 2, comma 3, comma 4. So these are the three difference values. And in this statement, there is a statement, statement number 4, c plus is equal to 1. It means c is equal to c plus 1. So it actually calculates the sum of previous value and sum of previous value plus 1. And at the starting point we can easily see that c is equal to 0. So first time when x is executed for x is equal to 1, x is equal to 0, then y is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So y will be executed for five times. For y is equal to 0, for y is equal to 1, for y is equal to 2, for y is equal to 3, and for y is equal to 4. It means for x is equal to outer value x is equal to 0, inner loop will be executed 5 times, and each and every time it will calculate the sum of present value and the previous value of c. So first of all, c is equal to 0 plus 1, it means 1 will be printed. Then 1 plus 1 is mean 2 will be printed, and 2 plus 3 2 plus 1, it means 3 will be printed, and 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 will be printed, and then 4 plus 1, 5 will be printed. So when inner loop outer loop execute for x is equal to 0, so inner loop will be executed 5 times, and finally we get the value of c is equal to 5. And then when we get out of the loop, inner loop, then there is a statement waiting for us, print c. So whatever be the value of the c, finally we get the that value, and that value is 5 here. So 5 will be printed. Now again loop will be printed for x is equal to 1. So x is equal to 1, again inner loop will be executed 5 times. Then 5 plus 1 6, then 6 plus 1 7, then 7 plus 1 8, then 8 plus 1 9, and then 9 plus 1 10. So after completion of the inner loop for x is equal to 1, 10 will be printed, and this process is going on for up to x is equal to 9. So inner loop will be executed exactly 10 times. So we can easily see that there is a continuous increment of 5 values, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and this process is going on up to 50. Because for each value of x, inner loop will be executed for 5 times. And there is a increment of 1 each time. So again, when inner loop is over, we can easily see that there is an increment of 5 continuously in this program. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. This type of number will be printed, and final number is 50 because loop will execute it 10 times. You can easily see that for x in range 10, it means in a outer loop will be executed for x equal to 0 up to x is equal to 9. Now I think the concept is very much clear to all of you. You can write your calculation on a paper and then check whether the output is same or not. This will give you a clear-cut idea about the how nested loop works. Next, there's another program here. Okay, this is the output. So, based on nested loop. Now, third program here. This is our third program. And again, this is based on nested loop, and also the conditional statement are also there. So little bit more calculation as compared to the previous one. You can easily see here, that is a program for I in range 4, for J in range 5, if I plus 1 is equal to J or J plus 1 is equal to 4, print plus and is there, and equal to within single quotes space is there, else print O and space is there, and then finally a print statement. So what is going on here? First of all, there are two for statements, and we can say that nested loop is there because one for loop is defined under another for loop. You can easily see that for I in range 4, for J in range 5. So one thing should be clear, that inner loop will be, outer loop will be executed for different values of I, and these values are I is equal to 0, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, and I is equal to 3. Then inner loop. Inner loop will be executed for every value of outer loop 5 times. Always remember that, 5 times. For J is equal to 0, for J is equal to 1, for J is equal to 2, for J is equal to 3, and J is equal to 4. So 5 times. So total we can say that loop will be executed, this program will be total values that should be printed are, that the for which the loop will be executed are 4 into 5. It means 20. So total 20 times loop will be executed in this case. Now within the for inner loop, we can easily see that there is a conditional statement, and this conditional statement check that I plus 1 is equal to J or J plus 1 is equal to 4. It means there is a choice between two statements. If any one of them found to be true, then the print statement plus should be printed. Okay, and there is a end statement. And means here that we don't go to the next line, and after plus statement there is a space, and then other character will be printed, or the when loop will be executed for the second time, after that will be printed without changing the line. And then else statement, if statement is found to be false, then else statement should definitely be printed, and there is a statement waiting for us in which O will be printed. And again, and statement is there, and we can see that here space will be printed. And after the execution of the inner loop completely, okay, there is a print statement waiting for us. It means line will be changed for next value of I. Now this is the concept. Now we have to only check what is the output according to that the condition. So the conditions are clear. Loop will be executed 20 times, and whether the value of and we have two possibilities, whether the value of if statement is we found to be true, or if statement is found to be false. If found to be true, then print statement print plus will be printed, otherwise O will be printed. So that is the concept. Okay, so 20 different values should be there. And when two statements or conditions are separated by OR, it means it will provide you a choice between two statements. If one of them should be found, if one of them at least will be found to be true, then statement will definitely print it. Now let us check out what is the output of this program. You can easily see that total 20 times here. So is that according to your expectation or not? You can easily calculate the different values that that will be printed according to the loop, inner loop and outer loop. Here my main focus is to tell you about the concept, not about the what will be printed. So here if you just find out the how many times a loop will be going there, a loop will be executed, you can easily calculate what will be printed according to the condition. Because condition is to be found to be true, then that will be printed, otherwise that is not printed at all. So that is the main concept. So just take a pen and paper and just write each and every value for I and J. Just write the output and check whether this output is correct or not, according to your expectation or not. Okay, and then after C, just you can see the output of this program here. That should be the output. You can easily see that in a row there are five values, so total 20 values are there, because inner loop will be executed five times here. So five values are there, and four rows are there because outer loop executed four times. Okay, so that is the concept. And according to the if and else condition, the output will be printed. Now you can see that we have only two options: either the O will be printed or plus will be printed. And loop will execute four times, outer loop will be executed four times, so four rows are there. And inner loop will be executed five times, so five different values are there in a row. You can easily see that. So that is the concept of this program. And according to that, whatever the condition is to found to be true or false, output will be printed. You can easily see on your screen. Okay. So this is the output of this program. Don't try to execute this program on the computer. First of all, take a pen and paper and just try it for each and every value of I. What is the value of J is there, and it will create a row, and after that you can easily see that the output of this program. If found to be correct, then it means the logic is perfect. Otherwise there is some mistake in your calculation. Now there's a another program here, program number 4 here. Not so much values that are printed in this program, so calculation is much more simpler than compared to previous one. And let us see that. Okay, that is a very interesting program here. You can see that an int is equal to input any integer. So the output is depend on the different values of n. And this is a question of a book. And there is a clearly mentioned that if you take the value of n is equal to 3, what will be the output of this program? And this type of question may be asked in your examination. that there are that what is the value of what are the output of the pro of this program when we will take n is equal to 0 or n is equal to 1. Two or more than two values are given, and for that different output will be there for the same program. So let us check it. First of all, you can easily see that when we take the value of first thing should be clear, and okay, wait a minute. First thing should be clear that one thing should be clear that if value of n is less than 1, it means whether it is 0 or a negative number, then first print statement, then the if statement should definitely found to be false, and invalid value should not be printed at any cost. Then else value should be printed, and within an else statement we can see that there is a loop waiting for us. It means that loop will be executed each and every time whenever the value of x, whenever the value of n is greater than 1. So if we put the value of n greater than 1 or 1, it means any positive value, then there is a loop waiting for us, and according to that loop, calculation will be done. And what now? Our second part. A loop is there, and within the else statement, and we assume that we take a positive value, then loop will be executed definitely. And here we can see that for I in range 1, n plus 1, suppose n is equal to 3, then how many times loop will be executed? Can you tell me? I just try it on a program here and wait for answer. If n is equal to 3, how many number of times in a loop, how many number of times for loop will be executed? Okay. If n is equal to 3, then you can easily see that for I in range 1, n plus 1, it means loop will be executed for and n is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, and I is equal to 3. It means 3 times, because n plus 1 is there. So whatever be the value of the number, that for loop will be printed for that number of times. If the value of n is 4, then loop will be executed 4 times. If n is equal to 5, then loop will be executed 5 times. Okay, because n plus 1 is there, and we count here, start counting from 1, and as we know that last value is not included, so loop will be executed from 1 to n. It means n times, n number of times. So whatever is the value of the n, that loop will be executed that number of time, but the condition is that number should be positive. If number is negative, then there is a statement invalid value. And what will be the output? And there is a print statement I into I, so square of that value will be printed. It means if we take the value of n is equal to 3, then square of 1 will be printed, then square of 2 will be printed, and square of 3 will be printed. Okay, that is the output. Now let us check what is the output of this program here. Just try to execute it. You can easily see that. Okay, let us execute it again. The value of enter integer, and we have put int is 3, then you can see that 1 is squared, 1, 2 squared, 4, 3 squared, 9 will be printed here. And let us execute for another different values. Enter an integer, now 4 is there, then square of up to 4 will be printed here. And next, execute it again. Let us take a value integer, okay, 10, or no, 10 is a much larger number, 6. You can see that last value is 36, that is a square of 6. And if we take a value 1, then what will be the output? Can you guess? for 2, 1 plus 4 and for 1, output will be 1. Because condition false only when n is less than 1. So 1 is also included in that case. You can easily see here. Okay. Now let us try to execute it for a negative value or a 0. And let us check what is the output. Obviously the output will be invalid values. Let us try to execute it. Now 0 is there, invalid value. Okay, for every value which is less than 1, there is a statement invalid value should be there. So that is the output. So basically this program's output depend on the value of the n, and the value of n will be given in your question paper, and according to that your answer may be vary, because it totally depend on the value of the n. So whatever is the value of the n, answer calculation will be according to that number. Okay, now our last program output in output based question answer, and that is the last program here. You can easily see here, that is our last program, and that is a practice work for you, or you can say that understand it as a homework for you. Just a very simple program here. You can see that nested if statement are there, so just try to calculate it, and after that whatever be the output on paper, just execute it and check whether the output is correct or not. Here the concept of nested if else, and if elif else is there. Always remember the concept of indentation, because this plays a very important role, and actually it decide which statement will be printed. So that is now you can easily see that this will gives you a clear cut idea about, and the green statement is a outer if statement, inner blue statement are inner, if else statement are here, condition statement are here. Okay, output will be C and D. Output will be C and D. So thanks for watching this video. Output based question answer are over here, and in our next lecture we do some question answer based on error correction and loop conversion. That is our last video regarding to conditional statement. So thanks for watching this video.